Greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. My name is Pastor Johnston Sakwa, coming to you live on the Scripture Prescription this amazing and wonderful morning. It's indeed an amazing morning the Lord has given to us, and I believe that He's going to speak to us greatly. Shall we pray? Father, we thank you and we honor you. Thank you for this privilege and opportunity you've given to us to hear your word. I pray that, my Father, you are anointing your word and giving us a heart to listen, and my Father, to meditate and ponder on your word, O God, even as we start this week. So I dedicate this session to you, that your anointing will be present, O God, through your Holy Spirit. We thank you and we bless you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Good morning, wherever you're following us from. I want to speak the word of God into our lives. And today I'm asking this question: whose will are you fulfilling? Whose will are you fulfilling? I read the Bible in the book of John, chapter number 6 and verse number 38. But to put context into this meaning, we'll start in verse number 37. This is what the Bible says: everyone the Father gives me will come to me, and the one who comes to me, I will never drive away. Verse number 38. For I have come down from heaven, not to do my own will, but to do the will of him who has sent me. Verse number 39. And this is the will of him who has sent me, that I shall lose none of those he has given me, but raise them up to the last day. The question that I want to bring to our understanding this morning: whose will are you fulfilling? I want you to understand, ladies and gentlemen, that God created man in his own image, that we can fulfill his purpose and plan. And so we are here on this earth, not by mistake, but because God wants us to fulfill his will. Now, the fundamental will of human beings is to worship God. If you read the Bible, the book of Ecclesiastes, you'd realize that the whole duty of man is to fear God and to keep his commandments. So it's very, very important then, as we live in this generation, as we live in this particular season, we shall endeavor to fulfill the purpose of God in our lives, to fulfill his will, to live according to his precepts, to live according to his will. Now, everything manufactured on this earth, whether it's a bicycle, a motorcycle, a refrigerator, a mobile phone, it comes with a manual. A car, it comes with a manual. Now, only a fool utilizes a product without reading through the manual. Now, this is the basic essence of a product having a manual, is because the designer, the inventor of this particular gadget, knows how it can be used effectively. Now, if you don't read the manual of any product that you want to use, it is possible you could underuse or underutilize the gadget, or in fact destroy that particular gadget. So then the manual defines the usage of the product. You might know what you want, you might know what you want it to do, but how it does the work is what you must be carefully take time to study the manual, so that as you apply, as you use the product, then you are using it with the best efficiency. Now, on this program, I've discussed something called velocity ratio and mechanical advantage, something I'll never forget as I studied physics, velocity ratio and mechanical advantage. Now, if you don't apply the use of gears and chains in an engine, then you lose out on the two concepts. So what is important is that all these concepts make it easier for the product to be used, particularly a product of mobility. It utilizes mechanical advantage and velocity ratio. It's subject for another day, or discussion for another day. All I'm trying to say this morning is that the manual defines how you can use a product effectively. Praise the name of the Lord. Now, when we discuss that, what will do you fulfill? Then I want you to understand, either you're fulfilling the will of other people, either you're fulfilling your own will, but you're not bringing it into focus on what God really wants for you. Now, for you to effectively function in this generation, to function in this new season, you must understand what it is that God wants you to do in this particular season. What is it that God wants you to do? When you understand God's intention for you, and the book of Ecclesiastes tells us the whole duty of man is to fear God and observe his commandments. So that is the whole duty of man. So you must understand, therefore, that God, having created and designed you to exist at such a time as this, you have got to impact in your generation by your faith and your love for God. You have to create your impact. You have to impact upon your generation, impact on your family, impact on the marketplace, impact on your business, impact in the will and in the guidance of God. Many people tell us the timing of God is the best. I agree that the timing of God is the best. But are you in God's time yourself? Are you in God's time? Are you in God's time to fulfill his will and his purpose concerning your life? This morning, the big question is, whose will are you fulfilling? Praise the name of the Lord. I purpose in the name of the Lord that God will allow me to be effectively used in his plan in this season, that God will effectively make it come to pass, that which is the desire and his intention concerning my life, because I endeavor to do and to fulfill the will of God in my generation. Be a man or woman of impact. Be a wife or husband of impact. Be a child of impact. Be a professional of impact. Be an employee of impact. Be an employer of impact. Fulfill your will according to the plan of God in the name of Jesus Christ. This is my prayer and this is my desire, that you will fulfill the will and the purpose of God. Shalom. The good Lord bless you. The Lord be with you in this wonderful week as we endeavor to fulfill the will of God in our time. Shall we pray? Father, we thank you and we bless you this morning. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your touch. Thank you for your power. We pray that, Lord, you'll give us divine enablement to fulfill your will in our lives in this season. We honor you and we bless you. In Jesus' name we pray. This has been your host, Pastor Johnston Sakwa, coming to you live on the Scripture Prescription, your daily morning dose of the word of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Shalom. Fulfill the will of God in the season. God bless you. Have a wonderful week. May the Lord go before you. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord lift you. May the Lord guide you in every step that you take, and we'll give him glory and honor. Shalom. God bless you, and I love you all with the love of Jesus Christ. I look forward to seeing you again tomorrow morning by the grace of God. Amen and amen.